Why use cloud-based image generation like ChatGPT when you can do it locally for free with full control and without pushing your private data to some data center on the net? With Flux Context, you can use simple text prompts to edit your private images in high quality. In this video, I'll show you how that works, including low memory options and a bonus at the end. Before we set up Flux Context, let's look at what it can actually do. In one of my last videos, I compared local image generation with LLM-based tools like ChatGPT and Gemini. They had some clear advantages, especially in ease of use. But now local image generation strikes back. You just describe what you want, and that's it. No more complex inpainting workflows. Using the same test image generated by ChatGPT 4.0 with Flux Context, we can change the cat to a dog, add glasses to the dog, add text to the shield, change the style of the image, and keep the composition. The only thing, prompts need to be a bit stricter than with LLMs, but that's a piece of cake. Like what you see? Consider subscribing. To use Flux Context, you need a working Comfy UI setup. If you are new to Comfy, check this video for the setup and this one if you're on Linux. These are the Comfy UI versions I'm using. If you've got an older installation, make sure to update. To stay flexible with VRAM, use my optimized workflows, free to download via Patreon, no paywall. We're using the quantized GGUF versions of Flux Context, basically a special kind of compression. From Balavin's Hugging Face repo, the Q8O model gives nearly the same quality as the original, but at half the size. If you still run into VRAM issues, you can switch to the much smaller Q5KM or even Q3KS model, around 5 GB. I don't recommend Q2K, the quality loss is very noticeable. You'll find all model links in this note. When using your source image, you can shrink it to around 35-50% using this note here. That reduces required VRAM and speeds up the workflow useful when testing prompts. Bypass the node to generate at full quality. No need to touch anything else, well, except the prompt. Be specific, and sometimes it helps to mention exactly what should stay unchanged in the picture. Now here's the bonus workflow I promised. This time we use two input images for even more context. Again, I've added nodes to shrink both input images if needed. The empty latent image sets the final size, lower resolution, save VRAM, and improve speed. I recommend staying around 1 megapixel for best quality. In the prompt, describe the relationship between the two input images. It takes a bit longer to run, but the results are worth it. Will you use Flux Context or stick with the cloud-based image generation? Let me know in the comments. And if you don't have a keyboard nearby, just leave a like.